Hi, I'm George Pearson. In this Adobe Photoshop video, we'll be taking this standard formatted picture here and stretching this out to fit the standard format that's used on sites like Instagram. Now, if you like this video, make sure you click that like button. Also, click that share and then share it with your friends on the different social media. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button as well so you don't miss out on any videos in the future. And to learn a lot more about Adobe's Photoshop program, take a look at my complete training courses, and you'll find a link right down there in the description. Okay, let's get to it. This is kind of a standard formatted picture here, nice vertical format, like if you're taking this with your smartphone. Let's say you wanted to use this though up on a site like Instagram, where they use square pictures as their default picture size. You don't want to crop in on the picture. You want to keep the girl here in nice open space around her, give it more of that open sense. So you want to extend the square outside and then fill in the background on that extension. Now there are some different tools you can use here inside of Adobe's Photoshop program to make this as successful as possible. We first though need to find our crop on this. Before I do that though, I'll take the background here. Let's just drag this down to the new layer button right there, giving us a new background. I'll just hide the original. That's my safety. Just in case we mess things up, we can always go back to that one. Okay, let's go to our crop tool right here. Now up in the options, you can set the ratio here for your crop. I have this one set at square, 1:1. There's the square crop. Now I want to have the whole picture inside of this, so I'll just grab the corner and drag this up to the top, and then we'll drag the bottom down to the bottom. There we are. Now there's a square format. Obviously the girl's in the wrong place, so let's just move her over to about the center. I think kind of in here someplace looks pretty good. You can adjust, maybe she's a little bit to the left. I'll go ahead and keep that kind of just off to the left a little bit on that. There we go. So that's about the right size, keep kind of the same feel. But we need to fill in this area and this area here. Let's just do a little check mark. And there is the new file. There's that new background copy. And you can, as you can see here, big open spaces on the left and the right side. Now to fill those in, at least one of the standard tricks on this is just to stretch your background. I just moved up here to the rectangular marquee tool. And I'll grab a rectangular shape just like that. Notice how I'm staying away from the figure. I don't go into the figure. I'm just looking at just background in here. And then using the Control T keyword shortcut, I can grab this and then pull this out. And it does stretch the image out. I can stretch that out. And that does work, but it's not great. Notice how it looks kind of stretchy in here. Let's just deselect that. There we go. So the rocks are a little bit stretched out here. It's pretty good, actually, but it could be better. We can make this better, this little stretch technique, better by using one of the tools here inside of Photoshop. Let's just undo that a couple of steps here. I'll just use the keyboard shortcut, Control, Alt, and Z, and step back a couple of spots. There we are. Let's just have our selection set. That looks good. Now the first tool I want to use on this one is a stretching tool or scaling tool. You find it up here in Edit, right here, Content Aware Scale. We'll be basically doing the same thing, stretching the image to the right side, but the Content Aware is going to go in and make adjustments to the picture as we do that and minimize that kind of stretchy look to it. So we'll choose that one. Looks the same. Notice we have the same kind of basic outline on this one. I'll just grab that, let's pull it out to the side here and let go. And this is actually better than we had before. And I need to be just a little bit further outside. There we are, just make sure we're clear outside. Okay, I'll just choose OK on that. And let's just deselect. Now it's kind of hard to see the improvement on this, but this looks real nice and clean. As you can see, the rocks look nice. They don't really look stretched down here. That's the important part. Let's just do this again. I'll do one more copy of that. Let's just make a copy here and pull that up. There's a new copy of the background. And let's delete this white over here on this side, magic wand, and I'll just hit the delete key. So that's gone. So this is basically the same that we had on that last layer. Let's do this the original way. I'll just stretch this like that. And of course, Control T to grab that, pull this out just past that edge. There we go. And then deselect. We can now look at those two different versions. So this is the stretched version, just regular stretch. Notice how the rocks are kind of stretched in here. And then this is the content-aware scale. Let me just go back and forth here. You see how it's the stretched version is actually stretched further, and the rocks are a little bit more stretched in here. And the seam is a little bit worse where the actual stretching happens. And even the land way back there is stretched further in the stretch one. You can see right there, it actually stretches out further. So the content aware technique, and that's this one here. It's the content aware scale that does a better job at that stretch trick. So that's the first part in here. Real nice tool. Now this only works if you have a large area to stretch. Let's look at our original again. There's a lot of space in here, almost half of the picture. You know, about 2/5 in there. So there's a lot of picture here to go ahead and do that stretch. And we're not taking it out that far. And for this kind of a stretch here, using that tool is great. And again, that's the content aware scale right there. Great for that kind of a stretch. And there it is. Now the left side is a different matter. There's a real small area in here. And we want to stretch this larger than that space right there. Let's just see what happens with the same content aware stretch. I'll just grab this again, just like before. Bring it up near her foot, but not too close. And then we'll do a regular stretch first. So Control T, and notice how stretchy the rocks get over here. That's because we're doing a long stretch on this. So the regular stretch just doesn't work. Let's just step backwards. I'll use the Control Z keyboard shortcut there. Let's try this content aware scale. Just do that, and then content aware scale, there we go. It's better, but it's still stretchy. So we're just pulling it too far on this for this particular area. It's fine up here, it's fine on the mountains, it back and ground, it's fine on the water, all that worked out fine, but the rocks just don't work. We're really just pulling it far too far for this to work. So we're not going to be using that tool. So what we need to do is to fill this area here without stretching anything. Let's just go ahead and deselect. Now we can use that or do that with a different content aware tool, and that's the content aware fill. To do this, I'll grab the magic wand. Let's select into this area here. There we go. So there's our selected area. And then edit. Come down to fill right here. And then in fill, set this to content aware. Mode normal, opacity 100, everything else exactly the same. Choose OK. And then Photoshop goes in, takes a look at this area here, and then it fills that in with this stuff here. And it normally does a very good job. Notice how it saw that line on the beach and matched that line. It pulled the horizon here. There are a few little spots that need some fixing. Let's just undo that, just deselect. Couple spots in here that need a bit of fixing, but not too much. If I zoom in, that obviously needs to be fixed. We can work on that one. And you can see the line right here where the rock texture changes. It's better down here. There's kind of a bad spot right in there. So it's not perfect, but it gets us most of the way there on this. So I need to fix this right here and fix this area right in there. And that can be done easily enough just using the standard clone stamp tools. I'll just come in just a bit here. That's pretty good. Go to our clone stamp. And I have mine set at about halfway on the hardness. And let's bring our size up a little bit. can see there's the brush size right there. And then I'll hold the Alt key down. Whenever you see that kind of a crosshair, you can see it better right there. There's kind of a crosshair thing. It means I'm holding down the Alt key, and then I click on that location. That copies that location. I can then pull that over to a different location here. This allows me then to copy some of this rock over this area here. And just by doing careful copying from here over to here, I'll just reset it a couple of times. So just randomizes things a little bit. And try to match the texture. There we go, a little softer up there. Looks pretty good. So that takes care of that bit, real easy. Luckily, this is a real random surface. It's easy to hide that kind of a repair. There's a little bit right up in here. So there's a little wave right there and a little wave right there. It duplicated that wave. I think I'll lose the one up there. So let's just zoom in on that. It's very small, but kind of a dead giveaway. So let's go back to our clone stamp tool. There's my little icon popping up there. And I'll bring the size down on this one. Normally I'll use the keyboard shortcuts to increase and decrease the size, but so you can see what I'm doing here, I'll use the slider control. And that looks pretty good right there. So that's at 14 pics. Come right over the edge here of the beach, right where the water hits the sand. Alt click right there and then just put that right on top, and that gets rid of that bit. Now the same thing up here, I can just copy this and move it down here, and that should work out just fine. So I'll start right here, I'll copy over here someplace, maybe I'll do right here. Alt click and then let's bring that down to match that other line right there. And it's going to reach the edge, there's the edge of that picture, so we had to come back in and adjust that, but I'll just come back a little ways, maybe right here, pull that over, and then just take that clear across. So it fixes that one line there. Let's see if the sky looks okay. I don't see any problems in the sky. Everything else looks good. Okay, let's now zoom out to fit screen, and there we go. So we now have our nice square format here for use on Instagram or wherever. And let's compare it to the original. There's the original, and here's our extended version. And we did that with two basic tools. The right side, we did a standard stretch, but we did that stretch with the content-aware scale right here, which really helps when you do that stretch technique. And again, the stretch technique works if you're stretching a large area into a smaller area. That should work out just fine. If you have a smaller area into a bigger area, the stretch will not work. So what I always try to do here is I try to do that content aware fill, and that's also edit, and it's right here where it says fill. Now it doesn't show anything right now because I need to have a selection in here. So go ahead and make our selection. I'll go back up here to this top layer and selection. So once you have a selection, you can then go up to edit, fill, and then content aware fill. And any other little thing which is not quite right, you can clean that up very quickly and easily with the, there it is, the clone stamp tool right there. Okay, so that's how we can go from this tall format or portrait format to the standard square format and extend the background out to fit that new picture. Don't forget to check out my complete training courses, and you'll find a link again right down there in the description if you want to learn a lot more about Adobe's Photoshop editing program. Thank you for watching my video. I hope you found it useful. If you like this video, click on the like button below to let others know. You can click the subscribe button so you don't miss any of my videos in the future. I'm frequently uploading new training videos. Don't forget to check out my website at howtogurus.com.